There was a toaster in the kitchen. He always followed all the rules. He said no to drugs and petty thugs and stayed in toaster school. Every morning he'd be waiting for the missus and the men. They would come on down in their dressing gowns and breakfast would begin. There were marmalades and syrups, there were breads and buttered rolls. He would toast them all, he was 10 feet tall, the ruler of the fold. But then one dreary weekend morning, the people left him all alone. They had gone away, when they came back that day, they brought a new microwave oven home. Microwave said to the toaster, "Hey man, you think you're pretty cool, but I can cook all this food if I'm in the mood to go back to toaster school." The toaster oven answered, "Who do you think you are? I will toast this place right up in your face. You've gone a step too far." Fear among the fruits. The starches were inconsolable. They were shaken to their roots. So there was to be a contest to decide which appliance was best. The toaster understood his enemy was good, but he was up to the test. Chosen to eat that which is frozen, the new appliance did boast. And the toaster oven answered, pride in his voice, "Try to wrap your head around heating bread, you're just gonna make it moist." So it was decided that who the people cooked with next would be crowned the lord of the kitchen hoard, and the loser would be second best. But they forgot about another, caught up in all of their self-loving. The people didn't want toast or defrosted roast, and they used the conventional oven. Soft-spoken and seldom used, baked a cake so sweet for the people to eat, and said, "My friends, you are confused.
We have appliances in the kitchen, both electrical and gas. We all have a way of making someone's day, now show a little class."
Said to the new guy,
"Man, welcome to the crew. I'll make a golden round, but for the quickest around, I'll send them straight to you."
And so, from that day forward, the kitchen lived in harmony. Everyone threw down to make the best food in town, and the people lived happily.